Hey, what's up, everybody? So now, whoa! He just attacked me from behind.
Let's go get in the water!
Oh my god, I do need to do this tech really fast. Okay, take two. Let's do it again. Hey, what's up, guys? We are at Clearwater in Florida. And behind me is the beautiful Clearwater Ocean. Apparently, it's the best beach in Florida. In 3D, yes. Why now capture us is the Ken Dao Eagle 3D camera. You should really watch it with a nerdy 3D glasses, the red and cyan one. Or the best way to watch it is with your VR headset like Meta Quest 2 or any VR headset. You keep walking and walk straight to the ocean. So yeah, look at the ocean behind us. It's very, very nice. And now let's see more footage of the Cool Cam Eagle. So the introduction you just watched might not be a comfortable 3D experience in VR if you watched it in a VR headset like the Meta Quest 2. I am about 40 centimeters away from the camera, and that is too close to the camera. I hope I make a point. We are now in a jazz club watching some amazing live jazz performance. The audio is captured by the Cool Cam Eagle. Let's take a listen. As you can hear, in-camera audio is clear with pretty good dynamic level control. This is a great little camera to capture live concerts and live events, and relive that moment in 3D. But hey, is it the 3D industry dead like 5 years ago? Who cares about 3D these days? With the collapse of 3D TV and 3D displays industry, there aren't many devices that can see 3D comfortably except inside a VR headset like the Meta Quest 2. Luckily, Cool Cam Eagle can capture comfortable 3D in 60 frames per second and publish directly on Oculus TV or YouTube 3D with the help of some FFmpeg magic. I will teach you how at the end of this video.
Ladies and gentlemen, I do this trick. I want a nice little sitting hand clap. Everybody, follow my lead. As we said, this is the show, it's warm up. No shows.
Suppose you own a VR headset and want to relive that special family moment in the metaverse. In that case, I think Cool Cam Eagle is great, especially now the install to see Evo is discontinued, and there's no consumer VR 180 camera anymore in the market that is under $300. Let's talk about the specs. Eagle captured 1080p resolution per eyes and 4K in total. 60 frames per second is the key to getting comfortable 3D in VR, as the screen is so close to your eyes. There are two 1 over 2.3 inches sensors with f1.8 apertures. The interpupillarity distance is 65 mm, which is a lot wider than 60 mm in the Canon dual fisheye and 63 mm on human average. This is probably why my intro talking head video is so uncomfortable to view in VR. But it does make the distant objects more 3D, as you see here. It is really a trade-off. Bad news for the pros, Eagle only has auto exposure at the time of recording. As you see here in fully auto camera setting facing the setting sun, the image looks pretty good. At the point of recording, Cool Cam Eagle stabilization firmware is not released yet, so I am using a cell phone gimbal. That is why you saw earlier that my gimbal went down and the camera go limp, according to Kitty. The camera has adjustable focal distance to create shallow depth of field in 3D, which I think it is a pretty cool feature if you know how to focus your camera. Here is the result focusing on 2 meters. Here is the result focusing on 1.1 meter. Here is the result focusing on 50 cm, half a meter. And here is the result of 40 cm, and you can go as low as 30 cm, which is best for macro 3D. Autofocus firmware will be released soon for those of you who just want to point and shoot. Ego is the only 3D camera that can see what you captured in 3D immediately as it comes with this little 3D glasses attachment. It is a great preview camera to have on a professional VR 180 film set, as the Canon R5C cannot produce a correct 3D image immediately. So if you use the CoolCam Ego on top of the Canon R5C, your director or clients can see the 3D effects immediately after the take to decide if it needs to reshoot or move on. It turned out to be a great tool for our professional film set, especially when working with clients or directors that never direct or shoot on a 3D VR camera before. There is an issue I do want to point out. CoolCam Ego is very easy to overheat, especially shooting in Florida in the summertime. I hope Kendall can fix this overheating issue soon. Also, the battery is not so long lasting. I will get an extra battery for any outdoor shoot or bring a power bank with you. CoolCam Ego can also take 3D photos. It takes 8K, 4K per eye 3D photo. Here are some cute kimchi photos. Look at that handsome boy. This is in 30 cm and 50 cm focus distance. With the background all blurry, 3D look a lot better. Unfortunately, 3D photo is not in RAW, only in JPEG for now. The video captured by CoolCam Ego can be directly siloed onto Meta Quest 2. All you need to do is to rename the file to end with -3d.mp4. I will recommend to release your 3D video on YouTube 3D, which is the best platform for releasing 3D videos for Meta Quest 2, PSVR, your old 3D TV, and my personal favorite, the Layer-In LoomPad, a 3D tablet that does not require nerdy 3D glasses to watch YouTube 3D video. My review is right here, check it out. The best way to prepare CoolCam Ego videos for YouTube 3D is using FFmpeg. There are tutorials out there teaching you how to use Handbrake. This is re-encoding your videos. Therefore, you lose image quality. Lots of 3D video demo I saw so far, including the Kendall official ones, are doing it all wrong. Ego actually has pretty decent image quality on YouTube if you follow my instruction here to do lossless metadata injection. I'm assuming you already installed FFmpeg for Oculus Quest. If not, please follow my tutorial here. Offload all your Ego videos into a folder. In the Windows address bar, type in CMD, or you can CD into your folder using terminal on Apple iOS Mac computer. Now command prompt is open into this folder with all your raw Ego videos in it. Copy and paste this command here. You can copy the code from this video description down below. Hit enter. It will search all your Ego videos in this folder and batch process them. Now you see all these MKV files. They can be directly uploaded onto YouTube. When you see the 3D icons turn it on, your 3D videos is working correctly. The retail price of CoolCam Ego is $369 US, and it will be available on B&H, Amazon, and all major retail stores. We all wish Kendall to release a true consumer level VR 180 camera, so it is kind of disappointing we only get a 3D camera. What do you think? Comment below. If you are interested in getting a free CoolCam Ego, we are doing a giveaway. All you need to do is to subscribe to my YouTube channel here and Instagram here at Hugh.ho. drop a comment on my latest Instagram post about this giveaway. We will then put your name in the raffle for a chance to get a free camera. I will DM you on Instagram if you are the lucky winner. If you are new here, don't forget to subscribe and give this video a like, and I will see you next time.